10, 10, 9, 9, 8, 8, 7, 7, 6, 6, 5, 5, 4, 4, 3, 3, 2, 2, 1, 1, 0, 0.
Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining us. That's right, this is the No Sound Bites Allowed podcast, and I am your host, Michael Voss, the Dragon of the Southern Tier. Happy to be with you here today. And it looks like all of our streams are up and live. We hope you see the program on YouTube or on stream.me or even on we're also on Periscope, so we hope everyone's going to see that. And for those who see it afterwards, not live, but afterwards on Facebook, we hope you enjoy that as well. So we're looking forward to CPAC. I hope everyone who has a question about CPAC, please contact us on Twitter at the mvconsult.com, our email, info@vossconsult.com. Please let us know your thoughts, what you would like to ask the people over at CPAC. But that's not the reason why we're on here today. What we're going to talk about is Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. Yes, we are. We're going to talk about Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez and her wonderful idea, which is called the Green New Deal. Now, we've been hearing about this since the beginning of the year, actually. And Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez has been promising that this is going to be the best thing possible, that this is going to save the planet. According to Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, we have 12 years to save planet Earth. And all of planet Earth depends on the United States becoming a green haven in the world, that we have to have zero emissions and to have all renewable energy in the United States. Otherwise, we can just kiss the planet goodbye, we're going to all die, and it's all over. That is what Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez has been promising and promoting and putting out there, and it's really not quite what she's making it out to seem. She's kind of left out a few details in there, and really, they're important ideas, but should we expect anything less from a woman who says she thinks it's more important to feel right than to actually be factually correct? It shouldn't surprise anyone. So, with that said, we're going to go right on over and we're going to check out some of the breaking news.
Newsflash.
That's right. And we're going to go right over. Now, it just hit Reuters today that just a few hours, actually about an hour or so ago, that the Democrats are looking to launch a 10-year plan. And that is to say that in the next 10 years, we're going to see the United States transformed into a green haven in the world. Now, this doesn't count the fact that China, India, pretty much every country in Africa could care less, and all of the emission savings that we've done here in the United States is completely evaporated by everything they're doing. That doesn't matter. But one of the big things that we noticed as the plan was talking about in Reuters conversation, that there are plans for this deal to modernize the U.S. transportation and infrastructure, decarbonize the manufacturing and agricultural sectors, and make buildings and homes more energy efficient. These are key words. Now, one of the things that's very important in this, and it shows up in the initial draft of the bill that was created by Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, and you may find it to be somewhat interesting, because it has no actual number. We haven't seen it put in anywhere yet. But Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez says in her deal, and it's a little lengthy, but you can get this. It's over at NPR. She makes a lot of horror stories. She's telling us that the world is going to essentially end. There's going to be wildfires, she mentions. She says that there's going to be 99% of all the coral reefs will die. It's going to cost the United States 500,000 million $500 billion in lost economic output, that 350 million people are going to be exposed globally to deadly heat. There's more than 350 million people in the world, but she's only focused on 350 million. That infrastructure will fall apart. Essentially, according to Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, who believes in how she feels, not what's actually true, the world is going to end. This is the apocalypse. This is the biblical end of the world, according to Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. Now, some of the details here is that it's actually going to cost, and if you look over that bill that she has out, there is no mention of cost, nor is there a mention of how it's going to get paid for. To give you an answer on that, it's going to cost about $7 trillion for us to be able to do everything that she wants to do. And that $7 trillion is going to be paid for by, one, increasing your taxes, which is something she loves to talk about, is increasing not just for the millionaires, but everybody. She's going to increase all the taxes for everyone in the United States, increase the taxes on business, which means it's an increase in cost and tax on the consumer, and she's going to print money. She is just going to print money all day long. Now, for someone who has an economics degree, you would think she would know what that kind of means. Because when you just see a nation that just goes out there and they just print money, the answer is you have a devaluing of that money. That's how you get, as we've seen many times in the past, where it will take wheelbarrows of money to be able to buy a loaf of bread. We saw it in the Weimar, in Germany, in the Weimar areas. We saw that in South America during the Banana Republic years of the 80s. It doesn't work. It's the most stupid idea you could possibly have in terms of pure economics. We'll just print money and that'll pay for everything. It has an impact. I think she seems to miss, there's an impact to all of this. It's going to affect people. You won't be able to afford anything. But that's okay, because she also kind of forgets the facts that are actually going on. Kind of like what was highlighted back on August 19th of 2018, when Stephen Moore wrote over at the Washington Post, and he was talking about the fact that the United States is leading the world in global, in climate change, or in reducing the greenhouse gases. We're already there. We're already doing more than Europe. In fact, more than all of Europe combined. We've had more of a reduction in those greenhouse gases. In fact, that was also confirmed by Forbes magazine, back on October 24th of 2017. It's a trend that has been happening since about 2005 until today, that the United States has reduced its carbon emissions by about 800 trillion pounds of greenhouse gases. No other country can say that. The next closest would be England, which has about 160 trillion tons. So this is enormous amounts. But at the same time, again, China, India, almost every one of the nations in Africa have increased. As a matter of fact, in China alone, used up all of the reductions that the United States have made. China has exceeded in 1 year. I believe they added 160 million pounds, tons of greenhouse gases in 2018 alone. So how Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez expects that the United States by itself is going to solve the energy, the greenhouse crisis that's going to happen in the next 12 years, I don't know. I'm sure that's how she feels, but that has nothing to do with actual fact or science, which is what she's trying to talk about. But it gets even worse than what we're talking about here. Because really, when you actually start talking about what is it going to cost, well, that's when you start seeing things like the report today from Reason.com. And one of the things I want to highlight is, What are we really talking about? What is this really going to take? Because there is an idea. We know what it would take. Back in 2015, Mark Jacobson told us, and that is that it's going to require installing 335,000 onshore wind turbines, 154,000 offshore wind turbines. That's half a million wind turbines, 75 million residential solar systems, 2.75 major industrial solar panels, and 46,000 utility scale solar panels, 3,600 concentrated solar power facilities with on-site heating storage and underground thermal. Okay, if this sounds like a lot to you, it is a lot. This is a massive redoing of the entire infrastructure. We're talking about $13 trillion worth of change. 7 is the low end estimate. 13 is about the mid range. It could cost more than that. And remember, what we're talking about here is changing everything. Now, when we looked at the bill that's in there, here's the other thing. Besides bankrupting the nation, or trying to, with $13 trillion, four times more than the United States spends every year right now. She wants to spend all that and do this within 10 years. This is ridiculous. But it gets a little bit worse, because within the bill itself, and here's some of the secrets that you didn't notice. Her bill is focused, and I do mean focused, on doing a couple of very simple things. Number one is that she wants to get rid of your cars. Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez hates your car, and she doesn't want you to have it. What she wants to do is have your car, have it removed and replaced with an electrical car. If you get a car, you may have to use public transportation, like high-speed rail, which we've been hearing about since Bush the First has been talking about installing high-speed rail across the entire nation. Still doesn't exist. That's over 30 years ago. But she wants to have it within 10 years that we're going to create high-speed rail, and so that you don't need a car, and you can now use the high-speed rail instead, and buses to get to and from your house to work, because you're going to lose your car. She's actually going to make it illegal that you cannot have a gas combustion vehicle within the next 10 years. If you love NASCAR, kiss that goodbye. No more NASCAR. You're going to be able to see electric cars kind of going around the Indy 500, not quite as fast. They may have to call it the Indy 250 because electrical vehicles just aren't that efficient. But that's okay. That's okay. She wants to take away all your cars. She wants to build a new grid. Now, here's another fun fact. The reason we can't build a grid right now, and it's something that's been attempted for the last 20 years, is that environmentalists will not allow state governments or the federal government to go into forested lands or a lot of the areas that we need to go in to lay down new electrical grid lines for the new power. And Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez again has said, well, we want to protect the environment, but we have to build a new grid. But you can't build the new grid where we have the environment in the way. So it's kind of a problem. But even if you could get past building a new grid somehow without disturbing a single tree or any squirrel in the tree, even if you took every single car, all 260 million cars in the United States at this moment, and you scrapped every single one of them and gave half the people a car, an electrical car, and made everyone else use a bus or a train and we're almost out of time here, and you had to make everyone else use either a bus, a train to get to work or walk. Here's the other thing. This deal also means that we're going to have everybody in a union. It creates unions and empowers unions. It gets rid of small businesses. It gets rid of mid-sized businesses and big businesses to create unions. Gee, guess who's going to get a nice donation to her reelection campaign. So she wants to create union jobs and force everyone into the unions. She wants to make sure that everyone has a minimum wage, a living wage, which is going to raise up the cost as it did in Seattle, as it's done in actually everywhere that we've seen that implemented. We've seen businesses close and the cost go up and people work less, and net, the poor are even more poor because of it. And of course, there's Medicare for All, which we know will triple the value. Now, you may say to me, Mike, what does green energy, renewable energy, which doesn't work, which is not effective, which cannot work by itself, and since she doesn't want to have nuclear power, don't know how it's going to work, but she wants to get this all built. 500,000 new power plants and energy collection systems. She wants to get that all done within the next 10 years. She wants to create nothing but unions and put everyone in them. She wants to get rid of businesses, and she wants to give everyone Medicare for All, tripling your taxes just by that alone, because that costs $32 trillion. And you got to say to me, Mike, but what does that have to do with clean energy? What does that have to do with renewable energy or getting the environment cleaner? And the answer is, it doesn't. It's just that because Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez feels that there should be unions and feels like people should have a certain wage paid for by the government and guaranteed jobs, and that everyone should have the same exact Medicare plan and health care plan no matter what, well, that's why she's doing it. So just to give you an idea, this is insanity. This is the definition of insanity. This is an idea that if Alexandria Ocasio is correct, if her feelings are right, and we only have 12 years to do everything she's just said, well, let's have a great big party because the world's going to end. That's not going to happen. China, India don't believe her. They don't care about her feelings. They don't care about the socialist feelings. They're going to do what they want to do. So will pretty much all of Africa. I'm sorry, Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez. It's not going to happen. But that's what I think. You can always get in touch with me. Let me know what you think. You can contact me at themvoss.com, our main website. You can reach me on Facebook at The Voss Political Commentary. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you would like me to ask any of the guest speakers and the elected officials that will be at CPAC, if it's about this or any other subject. And until later, I want you to have a great lunch. Enjoy yourself, and we look forward to talking to you again very, very soon. Thank you.